boys and girls, and welcome to Late Night Mop. I've been keeping my eye on this game for quite some time, as honestly, I've really wanted to play it, but I just haven't had the time, as I've been browsing a lot of Game Jolt games. But this game is made by Lixian, who is the editor for Markiplier. Now, I haven't watched anyone play this game, so I'm actually really excited to see how this is going to go. Because honestly, I don't know. I just know that this game was made by Lixian because Markiplier talked about it. Where I watched maybe like the intro of his video, but then it's just like, you know what? I want to experience this for myself. Where he talked about how Lixian made it and it's cool, and it's just like, you know what? I want to check it out. I'm probably pretty late to the party when it comes to this game, but honestly, hope you guys don't mind. Nonetheless, how's everyone doing today? Is everyone doing well? Doing good? Anyways, let's get right into the game.
Hello?
Hey! Sorry for calling you so late, but would you mind going by the house and do a quick cleanup? I made a bit of a mess, and I need the house cleaned, as I have some guests coming over in the morning. Okay, thank you.
Okay, this game's actually kind of dark. Can I have a light? Oh. A lot quicker, like right. Can I just leave? Nope, can't leave just yet. Okay. Pick up trash and put it in the can. Okay, so the lights are turning on as I walk. Living room, bathroom, kitchen, hallway, office, master bedroom, and master bath. Alrighty. What happened in here? Wait, can I pick more than one piece? No, I can't. One at a time. Okay, not too okay. I assume that's the bathroom got done. Hello? Door's locked, requires a key. That's it. Hello? Hello? What do they do in here? This couch kind of reminds me of the one that was at my grandparents. This one looks like they just had like a party and just didn't clean. So one impressive mop though to be able to clean off her. You know what? I'm hearing noises, so I'm just. You know what? No, I'm good. I'm good. I'm just. Can I leave? Can I just? Nope. I don't like that. I don't like just hearing people knocking. I don't like that. You know what? Let's just get the job done. also reminds me of some work that I used to do. When I was younger, I used to help clean around houses. Or when I also kind of worked as in like I kind of like a home setter for real estate. Where it sounds weird, but the job was also a little bit depressing, because what my job was I was working with this real estate agency kind of thing, where the reason my job was depressing was because me, my dad, and a few other employees would go to these homes and clean them up for estate sales, where if the house was dirty, we'd clean it up, we'd set everything out. So this kind of reminds me of that. It reminds me I'm cleaning a house for an estate sale. It honestly makes me feel a bit sad. Because it just felt wrong. Like working with estate sales. Those people moved on, so to speak. And it just felt weird going into their house and cleaning it. Or, I mean, I was paid well. I'm not gonna complain about that. And, you know, a job is a job, but it's kind of giving me that vibe. This is not ominous in the slightest. This kind of reminds me of one of the houses that me and my dad went to prepare for an estate sale. The plant. I also apologize if I sound a little tired or out of it, or sound a little different. Just, I haven't slept well the last couple days, so my brain's like, actually, it seems like it would be really easy to miss items or objects. Nope, I'm just gonna... I'm just gonna walk out the door. You know, it's fine. I don't... Yeah, okay, no, I'll admit that got me. The nope ending.
Well, glad to know I could count on you to get the job done. Oh, wait, you didn't! You made me look like a fool. Thanks a lot. Oh, and also, you're fired.
Between YouTube, Lixian TV YouTube members, very special to you all members of my channel and my game projects. Honestly, go check this game out. I'll put it in the description. Thank you all so much for YouTube members supporting me in my work, for supporting me back here, and thank you so much for playing my game. So, did that unlock anything? Job well done, very dead. There's cheats, fast whooping, and trash cans galore. I don't want to cheat. At least not yet.
Hey! Sorry for calling you so late, but would you mind going by the house and do a quick cleanup? I made a bit of a mess and I need the house cleaned as I have some guests coming over in the morning. Okay, thank you.
Okay. But you know, this game is surprisingly dark. Well, you know what? I'm just not a fan of just how everything is. Okay, so this is probably gonna take the longest. So let me just. I don't know if I have to do this in any special order. Honestly though, like, what would you do in this situation? Would you just nope on out? Would you stay in clean? What would you do? Cause I'm not gonna lie, I would get out. It's just like, you know what, I see a demon, I'm not messing with that. You know, you may be my homeboy, you may be my friend, you may be someone close to me, but I'm not gonna kill myself or get killed. I don't want the last thing I do before I die is to be mopping. Besides, why didn't you clean any of this beforehand? Why would you just leave it a mess? And what time even is it? I mean, it's currently, as of recording, 3:33 in the morning. So it's 3:33 in the morning for me, as of recording. 3:33 in the morning on a Tuesday, September 19th. Oh, time to grab the key. Nothing bad can go wrong. Yep, nothing bad. I have a mop. I will squeegee you. Just 3 rooms to go. I mean, how hard can it be? What are these stains? Why are these stains? Job. I'm just trying to work. And this is what I get. I will bap you with this mop. Do not test me. I will bap you with this mop. The garbage can. That's a nice bookshelf. I'm not gonna lie, that is a very nice bookshelf. This bedding reminds me of like a hotel room. Or a bare mattress. Have you ever seen those child mattresses that already have a sheet on it? And it's usually like ponies or flowers or a wallpaper design. The Alright, time for the bathroom. Should I be cleaning this? Is there an option to run? You know, I just want to skedaddle. I just want to, you know, get out. Hug the wall. Nope. I'm not investigating shit. You better.
Although you did break a very special and very expensive antique and left all the pieces for me to clean, so I'll be deducting that from your payment. So yeah, thanks for that.
You're welcome. Happy to be of service. Honestly, no, not too bad, but let's actually try the cheats on. Because I have a feeling very dead is me going to investigate that noise. Because this is something that you never do in horror movies. What you never do in horror movies, here's some survival tips. One, if the power goes out, just hunker down, you know? If the power goes out, don't go to the basement. Don't go outside to the fuse box. Don't go alone, right? Golden rule of horror movies or horror games or horror situations. You hear a noise break and you have like these shadowy things around you. You leave. You just leave. Time to move. Time to clean. Huh, guess I'm gonna die. Guess I'll do. You know, just. Oh, death. So how does fast mop work? Trash cans go. Oh. There's a lot of trash cans. You know, this actually really reminds me of when I worked with my dad for prepping the estate sales. Where we had garbage cans and just garbage trailers. Since the sensitivity feels higher. Door is locked. Okay. But even my character's like, okay, I gotta go. I gotta get out. Get me out. Look at how fast and efficiently he's going. He's a mopping machine. Really reminds me of prepping the state sales. I'm sorry if I'm just kind of rambling. I'm just excuse me. I'm not really sure how this is gonna go now. I actually do have some stories where genuinely I do like with some of the things I've seen and been through, I believe in ghosts and demons. I don't mess with that. Especially the last estate sale that me and my dad helped prep. prep a few years ago, there was like an antique Ouija board. And dude, that was like the only job that me and him turned down. Because even though we were hired from this company, like once, like there was a Ouija board and like some other, like, paranormal stuff, me and my dad, we declined it. We're just like, yeah, no, we're not messing with that. Like, our boss, he was mad that we declined it, but it's just like one of those, it's a Ouija board, like from, like, the 50s. It's just like one of those, I do not want to mess with that, because the house was weird, as in, they had, like, skull candles, or, like, the skull candles you'd have for Halloween, but even more old, more antique, so to speak, where the candles looked maybe about, like, 15 to 30 years old. Like, they were old-looking candles, where they're, like, the wax is incredibly hard, yet something about the candles made me and my dad feel uneasy. Where it was just an uneasy experience in the house, too. Where the attic had, like, a bunch of plushies and dolls, and there was, like, there was this doll called a Chatty Cathy that when me and my dad opened up the attic, it just turned on and started giggling. And it's, like, a toy from, like, the 60s. And we were just like, yeah, no, we're not doing this. I'm, like, that, we genuinely just noped on out. And, you know, I'll be honest, I'm usually not scared of the paranormal, but it's just, there's a difference between, like, video games, right? Games that you'll know will scare you, like Outlast, Five Nights at Freddy's, you know, or pretty much, like, any .exe game, like, you know it's, like, a scary story, but when you experience it in person, it's just such a different vibe. It's like something you don't want to experience. Where, even though our boss was mad, we weren't fired or anything, because, you know, it was like kind of like a volunteer style work, where even though we were paid, we weren't official employees, so to speak. It's more like hired hands. Sort of like a temporary side gig kind of thing. And honestly, you know, even though it was kind of depressing with, like, prepping estate sales and cleaning the houses, it was honestly a really cool experience in the sense of there were, like, antiques and things I'd never seen before, or some relics of the past, where it's just some stuff from, like, the atomic age, like the 50s, 60s, or, like, comics that you can never find. Where, yeah, the family wanted to keep those, which is understandable, but it's just, like, it was really cool, because a lot of the houses were still decorated as if they were, like, 30 to 40 years ago. It was just really cool, or you'd see, like, some collections that you wouldn't really think about. Where me and my dad, with a few other people, prepped this house that was, oh, wait, there's a kid on the ceiling. Oh, that's why I couldn't move. Okay, that's good. Where, you could tell it was a collector's house, where they had, like, a bunch of shelves with the different toys from, like, the 50s, 60s, and 70s. Like, still in their boxes or on display, and it's just one of those that was really cool, because they had like those wind up monkeys, like the symbol monkeys, or they had like an original pet rock still, like, from the 70s, still in its, like, box. And I was just like, man, that was just so funny to see, because you know the pet rock where it's just like, well, it's just like a real pet. Feed it, walk it, play with it. And then, like, I've never seen the packaging for it. Or, they had this, like, vintage game room where they had, like, an old Atari, like a 2600. With a few different cartridges. But they also had a, like a telecom system. No, it was cool, but it was weird because they also had like this thing where it was like a multimedia game system where it had like a driving wheel, it had a gun, and it took like triangular cartridges, which I thought was really neat. I've never seen any gaming apparatus like that. Apparatus like that. That genuinely got me. I hate that. I was just trying to share a story.
It might be a little too late to be saying this, but maybe don't go into my house. I remember I kinda summoned a demon. And totally forgot about it. Anyway,
how do you forget about summoning
a
demon?
Good and healthy.
How do you
and
forget?
Alive. Okay, bye.
Honestly, and that was Late Night Mop. Genuinely, this was a fun game. The scares were good. The game was good. But I'm just going to knock a couple points because it interrupted me during a story. But nonetheless, though, I hope you guys are enjoying like the short-style horror games. Alongside, if there's any games that you don't want to see, please let me know in the chat, in the comments down below. Alongside, on my Twitter, you can send me messages. And with that being said, thank you all so much for watching. I hope you have a wonderful day, night, afternoon, or evening. If you'd want to support the channel, I'll be putting my Patreon down below alongside my affiliate links for Coffee Brand Coffee and W Energy. May you all have a wonderful day, night, afternoon, or evening.